damages the environment. From Lancashire, here's our science editor, Tom Clark.
The wells are dug, the pumps are primed. Tons of water, sand, and controversial chemical additives are standing by. They're ready to start fracking.
The potential is huge. Not just us, but the British Geological Survey have said there's over 1,000 trillion cubic feet of gas locked up in the ground. To put that in perspective, the UK uses 3 trillion cubic feet per annum. Now, clearly, most of that won't be extracted, but even if a small proportion could be extracted, we can make a huge inroad into UK gas demand.
Fracking involves drilling more than a mile and a half into the ground and then horizontally pumping water, sand, and chemicals into the rock to release gas. Opponents point out it can cause small earthquakes and that the chemicals used may contaminate the groundwater. Quadrilla's first attempt to frack near here back in 2011 did cause minor earthquakes and a nationwide moratorium. That's gone, but protests have followed their every move. Today, campaigners lodged a last-minute injunction to try and delay operations.
This industry is inherently risky, and when it comes onshore, we need to have procedures in place to protect what happens if it goes wrong. If this industry goes wrong, wherever it goes, we need to protect the public when it does.
Even though fracking flies in the face of the government's climate change commitments, it's fully backed companies wishing to prove it in Britain. Quadrilla is confident it'll be fracking by next Friday.
These may be two small holes in Lancashire, but they represent a great leap forward for fracking in the UK. This promises to be the first site to be commercially fracked in England. And as such, it's kind of a test case that could open up the rest of the country to fracking.
Not a good day for fracking's opponents, but the risks aren't just environmental. The site's ground tremor could halt work at the site. Loads of gas might not meet investors' expectations, but it's still banned in Scotland and Wales. The dash for fracked gas hasn't started yet. Tom Clark, ITV News, Lancashire.
And finally, thousands of people have been filling the streets of Liverpool to witness spectacular giant puppets parading through the city. It's part of celebrations marking the 10th anniversary of it being crowned European City of Culture. It's the third time the puppets have visited, but it'll be their last. Stacey Foster reports in Liverpool's Fond Farewell.
This is the biggest little boy you'll ever see. He's 20 feet tall, weighs as much as 20 average human boys, and it takes 27 people to move him. The crowds queued for hours this morning as he stepped foot in Liverpool for the first and last time. Not far behind, Cholo the dog chasing him through the streets. Children were allowed out of nearby schools to watch as he performed tricks at the side of the road.
And they were dead big. Gigantic.
And what was it like seeing them?
Really amazing.
It's so good.
I like the dog because it just runs around you and nothing.
This kind of street theatre has been coming here since 2008 when Liverpool was named European Capital of Culture. A variety of different giants have climbed the walls, walked the streets, and sailed the waters in that time. But it's been the same team controlling their every move, using an intricate system of ropes and pulleys to bring these characters to life.